Inertia. 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 Inertia.
No, 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 no. Okay, no, no, no.
Ali, what's wrong?
It's all wrong.
What's all wrong?
Inertia.
What? What are you doing? I thought we were watching The Incredibles.
It's not like we forced you to watch the movie.
I'm sorry, I just couldn't take it anymore.
Take what?
The physics! It's all wrong!
The physics? What does physics have to do with this?
Yeah, it's not like you're defying gravity or anything. That's a different movie, Allie.
It's not a movie. Okay. Anyway, point is, the physics in this movie, completely wrong.
Care to elaborate? Oh man, things are getting heated up in here.
It's about inertia.
Inertia? More like inertia. Physics isn't important here.
Okay, shut up and listen before I use over 9,000 newtons of force to punch you in the face.
Inertia is the property of objects that makes them resist changes in motion. Newton's first law states that an object at rest stays at rest, and an object in motion stays in motion unless the object is acted on by another unbalanced force. This is sometimes called the law of inertia. For example, if a ball with a mass of 2 kilograms was pushed with a force of 10 newtons, it would roll at a rate of 5 meters per second. The ball will eventually slow down because the force of friction is acting on it. However, if friction did not exist, the ball would continue rolling forever. Now, the inertia of an object increases with its mass. Therefore, when a person is in a car moving west, they are moving at the same speed as the car is, although they may not feel it. When the car turns right to go north instead, the person's body is used to moving westward. West is to the left of north, therefore the person will involuntarily lean to the left while turning. Similarly, if the person is on a subway car that comes to a stop, they are used to moving forwards and will fall forwards when the subway stops. I bet all of you have experienced this at least once.
I guess we don't move in one direction.
We hardly move in sync either.
Can we take this to the back street?
Ooh, I'm a little scared. I should send out 5 SOSs.
I get inertia, but what does it have to do with The Incredibles?
Yeah, what's the point?
The point is that they are doing it wrong, okay? Look at this scene.
What do you mean? It looks fine to me.
So, when Elastigirl is on the car, she's moving at the same velocity as the car. Therefore, when she jumps off, it should make it really difficult for her to land gracefully. Elastigirl does step forward a bit, but not nearly enough. Remember, before she jumps, she is moving at the same velocity as the car, even with the parachute trick. When she jumps off, she should be moving with that same velocity when she hits the ground. But the movie shows her hitting the ground with much, much lower velocity.
Well, that one scene doesn't mean that the movie is entirely inaccurate. Like, remember that scene where Mr. Incredible stopped the train from falling off the track? The sudden change in velocity of the train throws everyone inside forward. Actually, inertia drives a lot of the plot of the movie. Without inertia, the people inside wouldn't have been injured and they wouldn't have sued Mr. Incredible.
It's possible that the scene with Elastigirl was just to show her superpowers and not an actual error. I think overall the animators did an incredible job.
Well, since they were accurate the rest of the movie, I guess I'll accept it.
That being said, can we finally finish watching the movie?
Yeah, let's go grab some popcorn.
I don't want to move.
Inertia!